Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're talking the latest announcements and updates for Microsoft 365. This includes everything from new Teams UI all the way to Microsoft Build announcements if you weren't able to make that conference. So definitely stay tuned and comment below with any of the features or functionality that you're most excited about. As always, if this content's helpful, definitely like and subscribe. Otherwise, let's go ahead and dive in. Okay, so before we get into it here, just a quick reminder that I do supplement this with a blog post with much more detail about all these announcements, helpful links, things like that. So definitely check that out after this video. Getting into it here though, we're starting off with Microsoft Teams as we usually do. This first one's related to a new channels experience, and this is essentially giving you a new UX UI for Teams. You can see that depicted slightly here in this screenshot that I've shown here on this page, but effectively it's able to summarize the information on your main pane, and you're able to pin certain conversations as well too for really quick access. And then you can see latest activity as well too. So it's kind of just like a summary of everything going on. I imagine this is where they're going to put Copilot into play as well too, whenever that actually comes out into a GA timeframe. So this is going to come out early June, be complete by mid-June. Piggybacking off of that, we also have this new experience to search within chat and channels. Again, it's on the right-hand side, as you can see in the left-hand screenshot, where you can search and your context is still be able to show the chat that you're in or your Teams channel that you're in. And then as you can see on the right-hand side, you're able to actually use context search within a team so that you're already positioned to search within that Teams environment you're already in, and you don't have to navigate and, you know, kind of filter that on your own within the top bar search. So just some cool capabilities. I'm definitely a fan of both of these announcements. This will happen early June and be complete by early July. Next one here is related to hybrid work. You're able to set whether you're in the office or if you're remote. As you can see in the screenshot down below, very straightforward, but kind of cool just to understand if people are in the office or not. This will happen early June and be complete by early August. This next one here is related to installing apps automatically based off of the approved apps within the Teams Admin Center. Essentially here, if a user was to be in the web browser and go to an application that has been approved by the organization, such as Figma, in this example, it would automatically install that app within their Teams environment as well. And this just saves them those steps and creates a really cool user experience. So this will happen mid-May and be complete by early June. Next announcements here related to webinars within Teams. So previously, if you were using webinars, you weren't automatically able to admit people to bypass the lobby, and you have to manually admit people into the lobby if they were anonymous users. But with these settings, as you can see in the screenshot here, you can decide who can bypass the lobby, and then you can say whether or not registered attendees can bypass the lobby, or rejecting anybody who can't bypass the lobby, meaning if they're truly anonymous users, they would just reject them from doing so, and you have to explicitly admit them into the webinar. So it's a great feature just to help out with that, just from the ease of use standpoint, but also maintaining security. This will happen mid-May and be complete by early June. Last one here for Teams is another security feature in my mind, but it's to block anonymous users' meeting chat read access in addition with current write access. So simply saying that anonymous users can effectively not see the chats within the Teams meeting itself if you designate that particular feature. Might be great just for security again, might be great just to talk without them being able to see your messages within the meeting. This will happen mid-June and be complete by late June. Shifting into Microsoft Exchange here, this is extending the message that I talked about earlier about work hours and location. This is the Outlook experience within your calendar view here, so you can dictate on your calendar whether you're going to be in the office or whether you're going to be remote. So just a unified experience here again between Teams and Outlook, and you'll be able to share that as well if people can have access to your calendar from a read visibility standpoint. This will happen late May, be complete by early June. Last one here for Exchange is related to Defender for Office 365. If you guys are familiar with the anti-phishing reporting policies that you can create or the functionality here, it's very familiar in the screenshot you see below, but effectively you can now do this with shared mailboxes and delegated mailboxes as well too. And this is the same exact experience, just extending that functionality into different mailbox types. Timelines for this mid-May, be complete by early June. Shifting into Microsoft Viva here, only announcement I have is the rebrand. So many of us saw this coming or already knew about this, but Yammer is going to be rebranded into Viva Engage. So if you currently use Yammer in your organization today, you may just want to give your users a heads up that they'll see this shift into new branding, and the URL change will happen later on this year. Timelines for this branding change, though, will happen late June, be complete by mid-July. Next, shifting into OneDrive here, this is again just much like Teams, a UI update, UX update for the sharing feature for files. And this also extends into SharePoint as well too. So as you can see in these screenshots, it's giving you a better user interface to add people, to share a particular document, adding messages, and instantly being able to see who can access that particular document. And then on the right-hand side, greater visibility into who you've shared the link with, and it bucketizes or partitions that into people, groups, and links. So just a better user experience, much more user-friendly on the front end. This will happen mid-March and be complete by early April. Okay, shifting into Power BI here, these next two announcements are actually related to Microsoft Build and the whole conference that went on last week. This is effectively the main two announcements that I want to talk about today, but I will link in my blog post the full list of announcements from Microsoft Build in case you want to check that out. These are the ones I just felt that were the most exciting. So Microsoft Fabric is a new offering from Microsoft here, which is going to unify the analytics that you have across your data sources and analytical tools such as Power BI. But it's effectively taking all these resources that you would normally have to spin up manually within Azure, obviously within Power BI, and connect them together yourself, and giving you a much more simplified experience. So it's really like kind of like a front end to being able to spin all that up. Obviously, I think there will be less functionality as far as the configuration that you can do and freedom to do that. But it's definitely a very, very cool offering, very powerful. It's in private preview today, and this will come out as far as general availability July 1st. The other announcement I want to talk about here is Windows Copilot. If you've obviously seen the announcements for Copilot within the Office experience, Microsoft 365, as well as Bing, they've extended this now into Windows 11 as well here too. There's definitely a lot to unpack as far as this announcement goes, but I'll link the documentation here below, which kind of details out everything that this is going to entail. But as you can see in the screenshot here, pretty cool experience of being able to access Copilot, to ask questions maybe about your PC. And there's also some really cool features for developers as well too, and the applications you could publish to Windows devices. We'll let you guys read into that. It's too much to cover in this video. The preview for this is going to be in June of 2023, and then we'll see from there where the general availability lies as far as timelines. So last announcement here is related to the Teams audio conferencing promo. So this is a licensing announcement. Many of us adopted this promo because it was $0 SKU. You could get audio conferencing here for a full year. And this lasted up until June of 2022. So this is effectively renewing. And when it renews, you're renewing into a paid offering, which is $2.50 per user per month. And it is simply something that you may not have to pay for. You may want to switch. There's another SKU that is still $0. So it's not like you have to pay anything different. The only need or use case for you going to the paid offering is if you need dial-out capabilities beyond US and Canada, which probably isn't a ton of us out there today. Just want to call this out because I saw a lot of people purchasing this, especially when I was at PAX 8. So definitely get ahead of this with your customers. If you're an indirect reseller, definitely work with your distributor. And if you're a direct reseller, you have the full autonomy and responsibility to educate your customers and get this aligned as well. Okay guys, that's everything I have for you in today's video. Definitely excited about a lot of these new features coming, especially that new Teams UI, as well as getting to play around with Microsoft Fabric a little bit more. Comment below with any questions or comments you have about these announcements. And like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, check out my blog post I'll link down below here with more information about all these and helpful links to additional resources. Thanks for watching guys. I'll see you guys next week.